Mornings are a busy time for our family. Between getting ready for the day, getting out the door, and getting to school on time, I usually don't have time to prepare a hot breakfast. Well, my almond and oat pancakes save our mornings so many times. I can prepare a large batch on the weekend, and they're simple to make because they're made in the blender. I can double the recipe, freeze the extras, and then during the week, all we have to do is just pull the pancakes from the freezer, stick them in the toaster, pour a little maple syrup and fruit on them, and a hot breakfast is ready to go, even on the busiest of mornings. We're gonna start with 1 cup of old-fashioned rolled oats. You're gonna place the oats in a blender, and you're gonna blend the oats for about 20 to 30 seconds until they reach a flour-like consistency. This is oat flour. Now we're gonna add the remaining dry ingredients to the oat flour in the blender. We're gonna add 1.5 cups of blanched almond flour, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda and baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of ground cinnamon, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. We're gonna add 1 cup of whole milk. You can also use a cashew or coconut or almond milk if you're dairy free. We're gonna add 1/4 cup of pure maple syrup, 3 tablespoons of butter if it's been melted. You could also add ghee if you're dairy free. 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 2 eggs. And now we're gonna blend all the ingredients for about 30 seconds in the blender. You may need to scrape the sides of your blender depending on the blender you're using. Now at this point you have a choice. You can keep it thick, which is how I like to make our pancakes, or you can water down the batter a bit with about 2 tablespoons to 1/4 cup more of milk. That's totally your choice. Again, I like to keep my batter nice and thick. Now you're going to heat a griddle or a skillet and go ahead and grease that skillet or that griddle. Once it's hot, go ahead and pour the pancake batter, then cook those pancakes for about 2 to 3 minutes on each side. You're gonna know that the pancakes are ready to be flipped that first time when the batter begins to bubble up. Go ahead and flip them. And now, if you're going to freeze the pancakes, you wanna transfer them to a cutting board or a baking sheet and let them fully cool before you place them in a container or a bag and place them in the freezer. If you're gonna enjoy the pancakes fresh on the weekend, go ahead and serve them hot, pour some maple syrup over the top, and enjoy them with some fruit. I hope these pancakes help make your mornings a little bit easier. Be sure to like this video and comment below, letting us know if you make the pancakes. For more real food recipes to help simplify your life, be sure to subscribe to the Live Simply blog and the Live Simply YouTube channel. My almond flour and oat pancakes save our mornings many times. These usually don't have time to prepare a hot breakfast. My almond and oat pancakes save